classic leadership and warfare fundamentals are pretty much the foundation of the Army's educational process for leaders. I mean, we really ground our leaders in the fundamentals based on history, based on our doctrine, which is built over, you know, what our experience has been in the past, and, you know, really the successes that we've had and the failures that we've had, so that we're not getting out into some great unknown. We're grounded in what works, what we know works, and what we think is going to work in the future. So I don't think those things are going to go away anytime soon, and they are a great foundation that we can build upon. From that foundation, what TRADOC is working on now and what we are incorporating into the educational process across all cohorts with regards to professional military education is really focusing on how we educate leaders to think. Are they critical thinkers? Are they creative in their thought? Are they, you know, we don't want them to be trapped in the dogma of something that happened in the past. We want them to learn from the past and to be able to take those lessons from the past, look at what's going on in the future, the future capabilities we've got, the future formations that we are building, and how can we apply the fundamental principles that pretty much apply no matter what stuff you've got, but using all that new technology, those new formations, to achieve what we want to get. And so when you look at that and you say, okay, we're going to do this in a multi-domain environment or a multi-domain operation, you really need critical thinkers who can soak all of that in, ask, do we have the right people here? Are we looking at the right processes? Are we asking the right questions so that we can get the effects that we want on the battlefield? Sounds pretty simple, but it's the fundamentals that set the foundation for us to build those critical thinkers to allow us to operate in that future environment, the multi-domain operations that we see ourselves conducting in the future. As far as things that we are doing differently, even though we're grounded on the fundamentals, and that's not going to change. One of the things that's recently happened here at Fort Leavenworth with the Command General Staff School is the tactical course that the majors take at the Command General Staff School that focuses on division level operations has really been transformed in the last about 12, 24 months. Whereas previously we were cranking out majors who could operate in a coin environment and understood, you know, how to fight in a coin environment, we've really changed that curriculum to create majors who understand division level operations and above, division level operations that are part of a joint force, and division operations that are going to incorporate new aspects of things like a multi-domain task force, or the different aspects of multi-domain operations that really start manifesting themselves at the division level and above. It doesn't mean you're not going to get those effects down at the tactical level, brigades, battalions, but it's really divisions and above where you've got the right command and control elements, you've got the right staff sections, you've got the right authorities to incorporate all of those resources or to request those resources if they're a national level asset. So here at the staff school, we're setting the conditions by creating a curriculum that really trains at that division level and gets those majors operating in an area that historically we had not been operating at. If you put it all together, again, we're grounded on the fundamentals. That's where we want to start with. But we've set the conditions so that the leaders understand the complexities of multi-domain operations. They know what it is. They know who is involved in that. They know who to ask for the capabilities that MDO presents us. And they can operate more effectively at the echelons, division and above, where they're going to apply those types of effects or try to get those types of effects to achieve the end state. So we've created those conditions within the educational system. We're learning more every day, and we're going to continue to refine our education so that we can get the most out of our leaders. They'll be those critical thinkers that can put all that stuff together and achieve victory on the battlefield.